Welcome friends. Today's topic is Joule Thomson coefficient, the porous plug experiment. Okay. Before that, everyone, first of all, we know one word, which is throttling process or isenthalpic process. Okay. Isentropic, isothermal, isobaric, isohoric. These things are discussed in earlier classes. Okay, isochoric means constant volume, isobaric means constant temperature pressure, isothermal constant temperature, and isentropy constant entropy. Similarly, then another process is the constant enthalpy process. Okay, this is called throttling process. During that process, there is no energy change, inlet and exit. Okay. With the help of this process, I introduce one coefficient, which is Joule Thomson coefficient. Okay, first of all, I explain what is the isenthalpic process. Okay, during that process, entropy remains constant. Already I said. Okay, first of all, if you see the diagram. See the diagram. So here porous plug. Porous plug means the small holes is also available in the porous plug. In another way, I draw another similar diagram, which is one, two. Okay, here some flowing fluid is coming and the area is continuously reduces, which means it is act as a nozzle. Then the pressure is continuously decreasing, velocity increases, then passes the throat part of the place, and then reaches the second phase, then that area is act as a diffuser. Here pressure decreases and velocity decreases. Okay, during that process there is no heat interaction, there is no work interaction. Okay, and also there is no velocity change, because inlet and exit having same velocity, because inlet not having nozzle, exit having diffuser, then how much amount of velocity decreases during the nozzle, increases during the nozzle is increased by the diffuser. Okay, therefore here there is no velocity change. Therefore, remember the steady flow energy equation. If there is no elevation difference, therefore G is at 0, V square by 2 0, and Q equal to 0, W equal to 0, then remaining things only H, therefore H1 equal to H2. The energy available or energy content of a flowing fluid remains constant. Okay, well, this is the concept of throttling process. But during that process, pressure and temperature reduces, changes. Pressure and temperature changes, but the enthalpy is a constant. Okay, this process is called throttling process. Okay, here they are experimented with some more construction, which is porous plug. The porous plug having small holes. Okay, initially some gas is available in the first region. That region, then pressure P1, T1, H1. Then we measure the values. Then during the gases is released to the second portion through the porous plug. Here also some P2, T2, the pressure is reduces, but the flow is very very slow, therefore the enthalpy remains constant. It's called isenthalpic process. Okay, therefore during the process, pressure temperature changes, but enthalpy values doesn't change. Okay, this is the isenthalpic process. Therefore, during the isenthalpic process, the pressure is continuously decreases. or increases. Okay, anything happen. Okay, the flow, for example, this side pressure is raised and this side pressure lower, or this side pressure raised, this side pressure is lower. Okay, the based on the concentration only, the change of pressure and change of temperature is occurring. Okay, then based on that, I draw one graph. That graph is temperature pressure graph. Temperature pressure graph. See that graph. P2 double dash. That graph from left side to right. See the graph from right to left. Right to left is the graph. The pressure is reduced. If the pressure reduces, temperature rises. Okay, if the pressure reduces, temperature rises. Okay, so this is the concept. But a certain time, that curve is continuously increases up to this. Okay, this point, when we reach this point, after the pressure increases, pressure reduces, temperature reduces. See that curve. The pressure is here 0, here 10. Then pressure is, for example, here 1. Okay. Then pressure is reduced from 10, 9, 8, 7, 6 up to 1. The temperature is continuously increases. Okay. Therefore, this region is called heating zone. Okay. And then up to the 1 bar pressure, if you reduce the pressure, during throttling process, temperature increases. Okay, this is an experimental data. Okay, then afterwards, further we reduce the pressure, the temperature also reduces. Okay, therefore this zone is called cooling zone. This zone is called heating zone. Okay, the changing point, that point is called inversion point. Okay. Please understand, this isenthalpy curve, the curve is drawn between temperature and pressure. Okay, throttling process means during the throttling process, pressure is continuously decreasing, temperature increases. Okay, based on that, enthalpy is equal to constant. Okay, this is the concept of throttling process. Okay, the pressure is continuously decreasing, P1 to P2 is decreases, temperature rises. But on a particular time, particular when the pressure reaches a particular pressure, again pressure is reduced, then the temperature is also reduced. Therefore, that zone is called cooling zone and that zone is called heating zone. Okay, this is the purely at a theoretical one, it is a purely experimental data. Okay, during isenthalpic process, pressure reduces, temperature reduces, as temperature increases. This is the concept up to the inversion point. Okay, beyond the inversion point, further we reduce the pressure, temperature also reduces. Okay, this is the concept. Then, I erase the things. Then, everyone must know the slope of the curve. First of all of you remember school level subjects, all of you drawn the graph and you find out the dy by dx, which is called the slope of the curve. Okay, if you draw one curve, y, x, dy, dx, and slope of the curve is equal to dy by everyone already calculated this value. Okay, therefore this is called slope of the curve. For example, the slope of the curve means here we have three variants. One is constant slope, another one is decreasing slope, another one is increasing slope. I explain one by one. Okay, explain one by one. Okay. First, I explain constant slope. What is the constant slope? constant speed, it's a constant slope. First of all, if you travel a bike in a flat road, drive a bike in a flat road, then you suddenly stop the vehicle, suddenly switch off the accelerator, the vehicle is continuously, for example, displacement, this is time. If you switch off the engine, okay, and unlock the clutch and don't put a brake, then the vehicle is continuously drop with its speed, and certain time it stops. Okay, therefore the curve is like this. When time when time is equal to zero, the vehicle is continuously stops. Okay, this like this. When time equal to zero, the displacement is highest. When the time reaches 5 minutes, the vehicle stops. That means there is no displacement. Okay, therefore that curve is a straight line. In the straight line, this dy by dx, I can take any place that value is same. For a straight line, the dy by dx is taken at any position or any size, that value is same, which is called constant slope. Okay, the curve having constant slope. But if you draw another line, x t or y x, the curve is like this. In that curve, that value, slope value, is the starting point, this is ending point. At the starting point, the dy value is higher when compared to dx value. Dy value is higher when compared to dx value. Change of x is lower when compared to dy. Therefore, the slope is high, because dy is numerator, dx is denominator. Therefore, slope value is high. Then at the end point, the dy value is small, dx value is high. If you take the same triangle at the top, then you have dy value is small and dx value is larger. Therefore, at that point, the slope value is lower. Therefore, if you go to the starting point and ending point, the slope value is continuously decreasing. Okay, the slope value is continuously decreasing. Therefore, if then at a particular point, this follows a straight path, or otherwise reduces the speed or reduces the problem. Okay, but in that line cannot turn. The infinite line goes, doesn't change this path, but that line is continuously changing its path. Okay, this is the continuously decreasing slope, it is continuously increasing slope. Okay, then I tell another one example. Y x, consider this curve.
consider this curve. In that curve, at starting point, this is ending point. At the starting point, dx value is high, dy value is small. Dx value is high, dy value is small. But at the end point, dy value is higher, dx value is small. Therefore, this curve is called continuous. In that curve, the slope is continuously increasing. Okay, the slope is continuously increasing. Please understand. Remember these two curves. This curve is different one. This curve is different one. It's constant slope. At any place that triangle having the ratio is having same value. Okay, but here the value is continuously decreases. Here the value is continuously increases. Okay, this is the slope of this is the significance of a slope of the curve. It is a major important role, vital role in the all scientific relations. Okay, similarly here also I take one slope which is in a for a TP curve which is dou T by dou P. It is the slope of the isenthalpic curve or TP diagram. Slope of the curve, this curve. Slope of this curve is dou T by dou P. Okay, it's the slope of the isenthalpic curve. Okay, you can erase all things. Okay, right. And here it slope of the curve is dou T by dou P. Here I split two. It's an inversion point. Consider this direction. Therefore, this line. Consider this line. The slope is continuously whether it increase or decrease. You think first. Okay. Just you think the slope is continuously increases or decreases. Just you think the slope is continuously decreases because here the y value is very high in compared to here that y value x value is lower in compared to y value. Okay, so then only that the curve is reaches one point straight line. For a straight line, horizontal line, the slope is for a horizontal line that x value is alone. There is no y value. Therefore, 0 by dx. Anything divided by value. 0 divided by value is equal to 0. At for vertical line, dy value alone exists, dx value 0. Therefore, dy divided by 0. Therefore, anything divided by 0 which is called infinity. Therefore, that line is continuously rises and reaches the horizontal direction. Therefore, that means that line from right side to left side, the slope is continuously decreasing. Then only it reaches the saturation line. Saturation means the horizontal line. Okay, then beyond the inversion point, consider here from 0 to the slope is continuously increasing, but negatively. Okay, because that y value, please understand, okay, that slope also decreasing, slope may increases but in negative direction. Okay, but in negative direction is the main concept. Okay, this is the first we know the thing. Okay, if I consider the curve is startingly increases and reaches some maximum point and then decreases. Okay, therefore the first from the right side to that inversion point, the slope is continuously increases. It is that slope value is greater than 0. Okay. Slope value is continuously decreases. Okay. Then here the slope value is continuously increases. What is the notation? Means what is the way it is decreases? What is the way it is increases? Which is the second question. Therefore, I draw one graph. Draw one line from this direction to this direction. Okay, I draw one slope which is 0.2, which is 0.1, I name. Okay, this is 3, 1, 2, 3, and from this direction dx is this length, dx is this minus this, value is positive. Then dy is this minus this, this value also positive. Then it gives the positive value. It is a constant slope line, even though it gives a positive value because dx value also positive and dy value also positive. Okay, but consider this curve from this side. This also a straight line. Here also the slope is constant, but that value is dx value is from this direction, therefore which is 1, which is 2, therefore 1 to 2 is a negative value. Okay, but the height is same, this by this. Okay, please understand. Point 1 to 2, this point 1 to 2 is, therefore x2 by x1, that value is negative because x2 is less than x1, because the line is directed this direction, therefore the x2 value is reduces, but y2 value is increases. Please understand, x2 value is reduces but y2 value is increases when compared to this curve. Okay, but the only difference is here the dx value is negative, here dx value is positive. Therefore, here both are same constant slopes, but here positive constant slope, here negative constant slope. Please understand. Okay. Consider the curve. x2 minus x1. Here 2 is this side, therefore x2 is higher than 1, therefore the value is positive. Here 2 is lower than 1. Second point is lower than 1, therefore the value is negative because dy value is same. Okay. But then similarly, draw another one curve, same curve, but direction is this direction. 1, 2, 2. Now, y value also decreases, x value also decreases from 1 to 2. Here therefore y value also 1 to 2 decreases negative, x value also decreases negative. Therefore negative divided by negative is equal to positive. Okay, consider the same concept. Consider the same concept here. C same concept. Here it is the inversion point, maximum point. Okay, here the slope value is continuously decreases, but that p value decreases, t value increases. Please understand, the p value decreases, t value increases. Therefore, dou t by dou p, here dou p value is a negative, dou t value positive. Then the value is decreasing slope and also negatively decreasing slope. Okay, negatively decreasing slopes. Okay, in that region. Then in that region, here temperature also drop down, pressure also drop down. Both are in the downward direction. Therefore, both are having negative sign. Therefore, here increasing slope, but positively increasing slope. Okay, please understand. Okay, this is the main concept of this Joule-Thomson coefficient. Okay, so rho t by rho p, when it is positive, when it is negative, when it is zero. Here at the inversion point, the dou t by dou p is equal to 0. The right of the inversion point, the dou t by dou p is a negative value. The left of the point, the dou t by dou p is value is a positive one, because numerator and denominator also positive. Therefore, both are negative. Therefore, negative root of negative is equal to positive. Okay, but in RHS side, the dx value is negative and dt value is positive. Therefore, negative divided by positive, which will imply negative value. Okay, therefore we understand from this, we understand three cases. One is negative, positive and zero. Okay, this is the experimental for single gas. Okay, then the Joule-Thomson experimented with various cases. Then he draw a final curve. From that, I explained this is an inversion point. The left of the inversion point is called cooling, because the temperature dropped. The right of the region, from this side, the temperature is increases. Therefore, the zone is called heating zone. Okay, the separation point is inversion point. Okay, then the Thomson conducted different same test with different gases. Okay, then he draw the cumulative curve. Okay, which is like this. Cumulative curve. Here, this is for one gas, this is for one gas, this is for one gas, but every gases from the, see the diagram from this type, this direction, okay, not this direction wrongly said, see the diagram from this direction, okay, the curve is drawn from left, so right to left, not left to right. Okay, but actually we are drawing the curve from left to right, but it's also from left to right. But the points are, initial points are available in the right hand side, and final points are available in the left hand side. That curve. Okay, it's a typical curve. Therefore, consider the diagram from right to left. Okay. Then every gas is having a maximum point, and beyond that point, the curve is deflected from right to left. Okay, therefore, every gas is having a maximum point. Okay, that connect that point, that curve is called inversion curve. Okay, the curve is plotted through the inversion point of all gases. Okay, then from left of these inversion curve, the region is called cold zone, cooling zone. Okay, right of the inversion curve is called heating zone. The point of the inversion, the curve, the curve is a inversion curve that at that place that Joule-Thomson coefficient, which is nothing but dou P by dou T. Dou P by dou T, dou T by dou P is the slope of the TP curve. That is called Joule-Thomson coefficient. Okay, mu equal to dou T by dou P at the constant enthalpy, because the process is isenthalpic process. This curve is drawn between temperature and pressure. The slope is called dou T by dou P. That value is called Joule-Thomson coefficient, which is denoted as mu. Okay, at inversion curve, that mu is equal to 0, because it is the maximum point of all gases. Okay, then already I said the left of the curve is called cooling zone. Here the mu is positive because dt and dp both are negative, therefore negative divided by negative, which implies positive value. Okay, then the right of the inversion curve is called heating zone. Okay, here mu is a negative value, because here dp value is a negative value, dt is a positive value, therefore positive divided by negative, which implies negative value. Okay, therefore from this curve we have conclude one thing. Mu less than 0, temperature increases, heating zone. Okay, mu equal to 0, temperature constant. Okay, at inversion point. Then mu greater than 0, then the temperature decreases. Okay, therefore during the throttling process, if you want to increase the temperature with the reduction of pressure, you must know what is the inversion point, because beyond that inversion point the temperature may drop. If temperature drops, enthalpy drops, therefore the process is not a isenthalpic process. Okay, for energy drop, then for the losses occurring, therefore you must know the Joule-Thomson curve and Joule-Thomson coefficient. Then you what is the value of when it reaches the inversion point for a particular gas, a particular situation, you must know these things. Then only that process is going on isenthalpic process. Okay, during that isenthalpic process, there is no energy losses. Okay, this is the main advantage. But we doesn't have enough knowledge in a Joule-Thomson curve and temperature pressure curve. It may create some losses, because beyond the inversion point, pressure reduces, the temperature also drops. Okay, the temperature H is a function of CpT. Then temperature drop, enthalpy also drops. Therefore, the enthalpy drop down, then the losses is occurring. Okay, therefore, during the flow, lowest limit to reduce the pressure? This must be no. Okay, then only you can rise the temperature during the throttling process, then energy is maintained as the same quantity. Okay, this is the main advantage of the Joule-Thomson coefficient. Okay, then mathematical formulation for the Joule-Thomson coefficient from the enthalpy relation, and the dh is equal to cp dt, v minus t dou u by dou tp, tp is already derived. Okay, the relation between delta u, delta h and the previous relations, and the topic I derived the things, therefore I directly take the equations dh equal to cp dt plus v minus t into dou u by dou t at the constant pressure dp. In throttling process, dh equal to 0, because H2 equal to H1, therefore isenthalpic process, therefore dH equal to 0, then minus Cp, here they missed one step, which is
CPDT, CPDT which is equal to V minus T into dou by dou T within bracket DP. Therefore, the dead DP is comes from the RHS to LHS. Therefore, minus is from notation, the change of places. Therefore, minus CP DT by T equal to V minus T into dou by dou T. Okay. Then, dou T by dou P, DT by DP is nothing but Joule-Thomson coefficient. Okay. Wrongly, they are writing. DT by, instead, I write mu instead of DT by DP. Therefore, which gives minus CP into mu equal to V minus T into dou V by dou T. Therefore, mu equal to minus 1 by CP equal to V minus T into dou V by dou T. Small derivation. Then, for an ideal gas, if PV equal to RT, the same concept, V by T equal to R by P. Then dou V by dou T equal to R is a constant and also P equal to constant. Therefore, dou V by dou T is equal to, because dou V by dou T at constant pressure. Therefore, here pressure also constant. Therefore, which implies same value R by P equal to V by T. Okay. Then here in that equation, dou U by dou T at constant pressure is available. Therefore, we can replace R by P for dou U by dou T. And finally, the Joule-Thomson coefficient is mu equal to minus 1 by Cp into V into T by P by T equal to 0. Because for ideal gas, mu equal to 0. Therefore, which means the slope is, for ideal gas, during throttling process, there is no energy losses because that gas is ideal. But in real gas, it is not possible. Okay, this is the Joule-Thomson curve tells the things. Okay, therefore, for ideal gas, mu equal to 0 because there is no energy loss for the ideal gas because it is an assumption. But in real gas, it may available either heating or cooling zone. Okay, therefore the mu value either positive or negative. But the ideal gas only, that mu value equal to 0. Okay, the small proof. Okay, this is a Joule-Thomson experiment and Joule-Thomson coefficient and significance of Joule-Thomson coefficient. With that topic, I wind up the third unit. Tomorrow we will see the next fourth unit. Okay, before that we did some assessments for the third unit through Moodle classroom. Everyone should attend the assessment. Okay, thank you.